everyone. Welcome to RayBiotech. My name is Brittany, and this is your Quantibody Array testing kit tutorial. I'm your technical support guru, and I have been in a lab for years, so I'm going to tell you how to get the best, cleanest data possible from the RayBiotech Quantibody Array testing kit. This video comes in two parts. The first part is what I, as a former basketball player, like to call working on your slide handles. My friend Brett is going to tell you the best way to handle these slides in a way that maximizes your throughput and minimizes error. It is crucial that you do not mess with these printed antibodies. The second part is I'm going to take you through the procedure. It's fast, efficient, easy to use. As long as you have your slide handles down, you will get amazing data that you can publish. The second part is also a visual manual. Everything that I'm going to tell you, you can also find by using your digital manual card. Just follow this barcode and it'll take you straight to our website where you'll pull up the manual on your tablet or print it out. I'm going to go ahead and plug being green just because I can't help it. Anyway.
Hi researchers, this video is an overview of best practices for handling RayBio, glass slide antibody, and protein arrays. After removing your array kit from the freezer, let the slide equilibrate to room temperature for 20 to 30 minutes before opening the bag. After unwrapping, the slide should be completely air dried before use, which usually takes 1 to 2 hours. This step is very important, as residual moisture can result in smearing of the antibody spots. Each slide comes attached to a removable chamber assembly and silicone gasket. Each well on the slide contains an identical array of antibody or protein spots. If you are using more than one slide, you should mark the slides to differentiate them. It's best to make a very small marking along the top or bottom edge, using a fine point permanent marker. In our experience, red or black ink can interfere with the array signals, so only use blue or green ink on the slide. Never write on the actual well area, as this will interfere with scanning. When you're ready to begin the experiment, be sure to orient the slide and record which sample or standard is being added to which well. Check your manual for suggested configuration of standards. To avoid smearing the array spots, pipette slowly and never touch the pipette tip to the glass. Be sure the liquid fully covers the array surface with no air bubbles. Take care not to overfill the wells. This will not happen if you added the recommended volumes of liquid. All incubation steps, including washes, should be performed with gentle rocking or rotation. We recommend a half cycle per second. Avoid vigorous shaking of the slide, which can cause splashing. We recommend incubation at room temperature. However, the sample incubation step may be performed overnight. Overnight incubation should be done at 4 degrees Celsius, with sealed wells to avoid evaporation. The following day, allow the slide to warm up to room temperature for 1 hour, before proceeding with the next step. Much like running an ELISA, good washing technique is critical. When aspirating the wells, tilt the slide and place the pipette tip in the lower right corner to ensure complete removal of the liquid without touching the array spots. To remove the chamber assembly, simply push the chips outward and carefully remove the incubation chamber and gasket. Take care to handle the slide only by the edges. Never touch the array surface and wear gloves to avoid fingerprints and dirt. After taking the slide apart, the final washes are performed by completely submerging the slide in wash buffer and gently shaking the tube. After the final wash, dry the slide by removing as many droplets as you can. The easiest way is using a pipette tip with gentle suction. Again, take care not to touch the antibody spots. After taking the slide apart, you'll see a green marking on the lower right corner. This indicates the front side of the slide, or the array slide. For most array scanners, the array side should be facing the laser. Always handle the naked slide by the edges only. If you wish to mark the slide at this point, use a blue or green permanent ink, and keep the marking very small. Never ever write or touch the arrayed well areas on either side, as this will interfere with laser transmission. We also do not recommend using adhesive labels or tape on the slides. After scanning your slides, store them at room temperature, always away from light and dust. If you do this, the array signals will remain bright for over a year.
Welcome everybody to part two, our visual manual. Note some information is not included. Within the kit, you're already familiar with our friend the slide. Hopefully it has been drying for 1 to 2 hours at room temperature.
The other components that you need are three wash buffers, two wash buffer one and one wash buffer two, in addition to a sample diluent. You also have your standard antigen cocktail, detection antibody cocktail, and your fluorescent tag, which is Psi 3. To minimize contamination, we have also included some adhesive slide covers to be used with each incubation. The 50 milliliter conical tube with slide inserts is what we're going to call our slide washer dryer. In your home court lab, there are a few additional materials that you will need. These include a benchtop orbital shaker or rocker, aluminum foil that we're going to use to protect our fluorescent dye, and a microarray scanner. If you don't have a scanner, that's okay. You can send us your slide and we will scan it for you for free. If your slide is ready, you are ready to proceed to step one. Block slide with sample diluent. Every place on that slide that does not have an antibody is going to be blocked this diluent, and that's going to prevent external contamination. Using a multi-channel, pipette 100 microliters of sample diluent into each well. Cover with adhesive film and incubate on the rocker for 30 minutes. Now this can incubate for up to 2 hours. While that is incubating, we're going to prepare our reagents. So first is going to be the three wash buffers. That's going to be one part wash buffer and 19 parts deionized water. The easiest way to use these wash buffers is with trays and a multi-channel.
The Quantibody Array is quantitative proteomics. So that means we're going to have a numeric value for the concentration of each antigen in the sample. So to do that, we need to generate a standard curve. On the slides that don't have the standard curve, you just need two standards, the blank and standard three.
If you go to our website and look under the Resources tab, you will find Array Frequently Asked Questions. Scroll all the way down and click the How Many Slides question. Follow the link and it will give you a multi-slide calibration guide if you would like to increase your sample per kit quantity. We recommend a maximum of every four slides with standard three and a control on all slides that do not have a standard curve. And that's going to help us calibrate those slides. The first thing you're going to do is grab your lyophilized standard with your multiple antigens in it and your sample diluent. Then reconstitute the powder with 500 microliters. Note that the antigens in the standard have unique concentration ranges and will be diluted in the same proportion for 7 dilutions. Mix gently with repeated pipetting or multiple inversions. Then get 7 microfuge tubes. We recommend a 1.5 microliter with a tapered bottom. Be sure to label them 2 through 7 and then 0 as your control. Note, all standards and samples should be diluted and prepared on ice, which is why we have our trusty ice bucket underneath the tubes. This dilution is a 1/3 dilution where we're going to pipette 100 microliters passaging through 200 microliters. So the first thing we're going to do is add 200 microliters into tubes 2 through 7. For the best result, always spin the volume down prior to beginning the serial dilution. Next, add 100 microliters to the control. And it is always a pro tip to keep the control separate from the other tubes to prevent accidental passage from the serial dilution into the control. We don't want any antigens in there as that is a true blank. Now, as I mentioned before, this is a multiplex serial dilution, so each individual antigen within the lyophilized standard is going to be diluted in the same proportion down from the first tube to dilution 7 within their very own concentration ranges. Pipette 100 microliters from the lyophilized standard into tube 2. Remember to mix gently and thoroughly and change tips every time. Keep those values precise. We don't want the higher concentration of tube 2 to increase the concentration of tube 7 incidentally. Passage from tube 2 to 3, mix thoroughly, eject the tip, get a new one, and complete that cycle down through tube 7. Remember not to passage from the tube 7 to the control.
Now remember, when it comes comes to your samples, you never want to use an undiluted sample. That's because we want to minimize external matrix effects. With serum and plasma, that's really easy. It's just we recommend a 2x dilution.
With cell culture samples, use serum-free conditioned media if possible. If serum-containing conditioned media is required, it's highly recommended that complete medium is used as a control, as many sera contain cytokines. In between each incubation, you will do 7 wash steps. First, carefully decant the sample diluent. Add wash buffer to the tray, and then pipette with the multi-channel 150 microliters onto the slide. You'll then incubate for 5 minutes and repeat this process 5 times. Remember, it is important to remove the wash buffer thoroughly in between washes. Note that during wash steps, you do not have to cover with adhesive film. Next, do the same thing with wash buffer 2, only this time it's 2 washes, 5 minutes each. Once that wash buffer has been removed, you can add your standard and samples. Don't forget to add them according to your plate map to ensure your data is accurate. Seal the slide and incubate for 1 to 2 hours. Now that the antigens have been captured, we need to detect them using a biotinylated detection antibody. Remember, there are multiple detection antibodies in the cocktail, each formulated to minimize cross-reactivity. First, reconstitute the vial by adding 1.4 milliliters of sample diluent, mixed thoroughly and gently by repeated inversions or repeated pipetting. Repeat the same wash buffer steps with wash buffer 1 and wash buffer 2 as you did between the previous incubation. Once the slide is dry, you are now ready to put on your detection antibody with 80 microliters to each well. Incubate covered for 1 to 2 hours. In the last incubation step, we're going to incubate our fluorescent dye C3. So get out your sample diluent and your streptavidin dye, which should come in that brown light sealed container. Add 1.4 milliliters sample diluent to the vial and mix gently, just as you did with the biotinylated antibody detection cocktail. Using the multi-channel, add 80 microliters to the slide. Seal the slide for the last time with the adhesive film, as we would like to protect the fluorescent signal on the slide. We're going to wrap it in aluminum foil during its 1 to 2 hour incubation on the orbital rocker. Following the last incubation step, you may remove the slide from the foil. Also remove the adhesive film, and then remove the liquid. At this point, you may remove the slide from the slide holder gasket. Again, be careful not to touch your fingers to the slide that has the antibodies on that. If you push too hard, you are at risk of your thumb accidentally touching the slide. In this case, too much force was used. So remember to be gentle when you separate the slide from the holder. The washes we are going to complete prior to placing it on the microarray scanner are all completed in the slide washer dryer. Remember to fully immerse the slide, which is about 30 milliliters. Luckily, it's only 2 washes this time. Wash buffer 1 for 15 minutes and then wash buffer 2 for 5 minutes. After the last wash, it is extraordinarily important to make sure the slide is completely dry. Congratulations, you are now ready to read your slide, or as we said before, if you do not have a slide reader, feel free to ship it to us in one of those conical tubes as it's completely dry and in the dark, and we will read it for you with our free slide scanning service.
Great job, guys. Remember these pro tips from your proteomic pros. 1. completely remove the liquid prior to the next application of liquid, no matter what it is. Remember, even if it's a wash buffer or a incubation, the next steps are going to be much cleaner if all of that liquid is completely gone. Two, don't touch the antibodies. I've said this before and I mean it. Don't do it. Three, remember to mix everything gently. And then four, we haven't gone over. Those proteins, like I said before, have their own concentration ranges. That means those with higher concentration ranges, say 1 nanogram per mil, are going to have a much higher fluorescence than those that have picogram levels per mil. So for that reason, you might have to do 3 different reads with fluorescence. So the highest, the middle, and then the lowest one, PMT values. And those are also calibrated with that standard curve. Also remember that certain values may vary from manual to manual. Some are going to be more custom within a Quantibody array, and then others are going to be more replicable across different cellular systems. So for that reason, if any of the values from your manual are different than what you see here, it's important that you follow the manual that you can find on our website. And if you have any questions, our technical support team can be found at this email right here, and we are more than happy to assist you in reading data, analyzing it, extracting it, anything that you might need to help you understand the targets in your physiological pathway of choice. Here are a few publications that have been found from these Quantibody arrays already.